I want to talk to you today about how it all started and why you took on this role and why you thought it was important for Manulife.
I was very flattered when I was asked to take over the responsibility of promoting the immigrant integration initiatives in Toronto. Anybody that looks at the demographics of our country understands that immigration is vital and that we won't be much of a country if it wasn't for immigrants. The diversity that the immigrant experience brings to our country, I think, makes us a much more interesting and ultimately more competitive place.
So why should business care about immigration and skilled immigrants per se?
Well, I don't know how they cannot care. The facts are that our country, to sustain its standard of living and to sustain its economy, needs immigration. You know, it's a demographic reality. We're not reproducing. No, very few countries are. Without immigration, our population would decline. Some 250,000 or more people come to this country every year. That's a lot as a percentage of our population. And then there's also the issue that, you know, these are your customers. I mean, these are your markets. In our particular case, because we happen to be, Manulife happens to be an international company, we have found it enormously beneficial to draw upon, you know, the pool of talented immigrants that came to this country.
Dominic, we're in the middle of rather challenging economic times. Even though people say we're in a recovery, it seems it's a jobless recovery. Is TRIEC still relevant?
Well, I would say more than ever it's more relevant. Again, coming back to the business case, one of the things that immigration brings to your country is diversity, and we all know that competing ideas and competing ways of looking at issues are always end up that you end up get a better resolution of a challenge. Canada has got a very generous policy of immigration, as I said earlier, but generous provided you've got post-secondary education, you've got the skills that are needed by this country. You know, the immigrants that come here, I think, come with enormous resources and capability, and I'm not sure that everybody understands that, and that we could do something to employ all of those talents very, very quickly, I think, is even more necessary at a time when the economy is undergoing a slowdown. More than ever, we need to exploit and fully utilize the talents that are present amongst us than ever before.
How do you know that TRIEC's made a difference?
I look at the attention that the whole issue of immigrant integration has today, the profile it has. I mean, it's got a much, much higher profile. There isn't a day that goes by that you can't read some story in the news about that's connected to the initiative. I think the attention that's being paid by institutions like ours, just about every large institution, all the corporate community certainly has an awareness and has programs, has raised this issue to, you know, the front burner as opposed to something that's percolating in the back. I look at our own company here where, I don't know, over the past 6 years, we have 50 or so, 60 people that have come through and been mentored or interned and led to jobs, most of them with us, some with others. Well, you multiply that out by the number of participants, number of organizations that are involved, and that's a lot of people.
What's made you proudest of
well, you know,
when,
what's made me proudest is just looking at, my own contacts with people, not just in our company, but when we have our little get-togethers there where we celebrate various internships or mentorships or other initiatives, and looking at the sea of people and, you know, the success stories are profiled where someone got a job or got promoted or got recognized. I mean, this is a win-win, a win for those of us who, you know, make the effort to try to help, and it's a win, obviously, if we can expedite, as I said earlier, getting people's credentials recognized, getting them practicing, getting them working at a level that they're trained and qualified for.
What do you wish for TRIEC?
Well, some of the things that I wished initially are already happening. The fact that other cities are starting to take up the model,
the fact that governments are listening, that we're having an influence in the debate, the fact that professional organizations are attentive to the representations we're making, the fact that, you know, you're successful. Successful in, as I said, being received as someone credible that has something to say on the whole issue. All of these are things that I think I feel good about, and I think others will feel good about too.